Good morning, good evening, or good day. I have no idea what time it is where you're at. Right now it's 8 o'clock at night. I should probably be home. Today we are going to talk about gimbals. What is the best gimbal in 2018? Before we get started, I want to tell you, please, and I'm begging you, please, before you buy a gimbal, ask me why. I've owned so many gimbals, and you know, in fact, hang on. All right, this is a little bit overkill, but seriously, I've owned so many gimbals that I'm a good person to tell you which one you should and should not buy depending on whichever cam you have. So if you have a specific camera you wanna ask questions about, just ask me and I'll save you the trouble of wasting your money and buying the wrong gimbal. So today, instead of talking about all the gimbals, cause those other big ones I just took off here are Ronins, and the only reason you really need a Ronin is if you have a really big camera. And if you need a big carrying camera gimbal, get a Ronin. As you see, I have a lot of gimbals, but I've owned over 30 gimbals over the years. That's borderline, as I say, it's borderline ridiculous. That actually is ridiculous. It's not borderline, that's beyond ridiculous. But today we're gonna talk particularly about pistol grip gimbals. So this is the first one I'm gonna talk about today. This is called the Pilotfly H2. This for me was an incredible gimbal. Why? It's super buttery smooth. I bought this particularly for my A7S Mark II. Fabulously, kinda. When you're buying a gimbal, something to notate, you should always get a gimbal that is a little bit stronger than what it needs to be. So what I mean by that is, this had a capacity of, I don't know, it was like 4.4 pounds, something like that. My Canon, I'm sorry, I don't have Canon anymore. My Sony A7S Mark II and my A7Rs and all the other cameras that we use, they're slightly lighter than this. So it was just a little bit stronger than it needed to be, which really helped it get through some tight turns or some fast movements, and it was really awesome. However, it wasn't quite the strongest. What I mean by that is it had to be perfectly balanced on there, otherwise you'll get some wobble, which causes some jello in your footage. Jello is no bueno. That was Spanish for is not good. Because you can't fix jello. No matter what you want to tell me, what you say, what kind of software you have, you can't fix it. Because if you could, I'd know how. The other annoying thing is you have to use their plate here, which is annoying because every time you want to take the camera on and off, you have to twist it on and off. Now they have a replacement plate for a different kind of Manfrotto plate that you can put on here, but it's not the Manfrotto plate that I use, so it didn't mesh with me well. The next gimbal I want to talk about is the Zhiyun. I can't say it correctly. That's not one of the three languages that I speak, but we'll just go with it. Zhiyun Crane V2. This is one of the newer models that they've come out with, and this is a fantastic gimbal. Very easily does the upside down mode. The really cool thing that this gimbal brought to the table was the ability to be able to add this plate, this Manfrotto plate that I use. I believe this is the Manfrotto plate 323 RC2. I use this plate for almost everything I do. The reason why this is so nice to have is when you're shooting run and gun and you need to take your camera off quickly from this to something else and put it onto, like, make, for example, like a shoulder mount or a tripod, you can easily do it. Not a great kind of head or plate for doing pan movements, but we don't do that because we don't have a ponytail and fanny packs and a big belly and black clothes on. Yeah. The interesting fact about this is that this actually has the capacity of less weight, but it was able to pull off carrying this plate and the camera where this would not. So this is it, guys. This is the gimbal of the world. It's the Zhiyun 2. This gimbal is the best gimbal of 2018 in possibly the world. Or at least of 2018. And let me tell you why. Let's start from the bottom and work our way up. So on the bottom, you notice some feet down here. Yes, the other two gimbals that I had up on here, they had feet as well, but I had to put those on. I had to buy those separately. These actually come with this model, which are incredible, by the way. Those other little tripod legs were actually Manfrotto's. This is their brand, and these are about 100 times better than the Manfrotto's. It's nice because when you want to set your camera down like that, you don't have to lay it down like I used to have to do over here before I had these feet on these gimbals. The other thing that's super fantabulous about this gimbal is the LCD panel actually here on the side that tells you exactly what settings you're on. It's so much easier to know what setting you're on when you could actually just read it and it tells you right there. The controls on the back are smoother. On the side, there is a dial where you can actually pull focus if you have a Canon. So this doesn't work for me yet. But with a software update, maybe it will, maybe it won't. But I'm not real worried about it because I'm not a big pull focus kind of guy. If they do activate this for the Sonys, I'll probably have to make a whole separate video how to pull focus while running. But still, that's really cool that they then added this feature on there where you can actually connect directly to the camera from this device and adjust your focus on the fly. Incredible stuff. The battery life on this one, it's all right. You know, it's a big gimbal, right? And it's carrying bigger things. Just like my drones, when you have one of the bigger drones carrying more weight, it's gonna fly for less time than a Phantom, right? You can use it all day long. I doubt you will outlast the gimbal because the thing is, in between your shoots, you're gonna turn it on and off. And with this, you're able to go all day without having to recharge. The other really neat thing about this is very easily, you can actually untwist this, and inside here are the batteries. They're right there. I don't know what they call them. They look like Tesla batteries, but they're probably not. However, you can replace these. So if you want to get additional batteries and you run out of battery, you can just plop some new batteries in there and just keep on filming. The other smaller versions can do that too, but the Pilotfly definitely cannot. Now onto the most amazing part about this gimbal. Its motors, its strength, it has pure fury. It can carry 7 pounds. This is a pistol grip gimbal. That's insane. What's that mean to me and what it should mean to you is that when you're really putting some pressure on a gimbal, when you're really in those corners or when you're in a car and you're going fast and you hit, you know, a really heavy force, this gimbal's still gonna be able to fly and not break off. And when I say break off, usually with gimbals and you're using it, you're putting too much force or weight on it, it will just go like this and you have to get it back to balance. I don't know about you, but if it's going from filming to this, it's probably unusable footage. This gimbal can handle it. Let me show you. Again, I can put my mount on here, I clip it in, voila. It can handle a lot of weight, pressure, it can hit on it, and it's still gonna just stay right there. I don't advise hitting it though. Now, let's take it up another level of, holy heck, this thing is awesome. All right, so I put on this magicness. Now, if you don't know how to balance a gimbal, watch a tutorial, not mine, because that's too boring of a tutorial for me to make. But you will notice, you can move it in any which way, basically, and it's not gonna fall. Here it is. This is the amazingness. This is incredible. I can put a microphone on top of my mount, on top of my camera. I have a microphone. And some of you are like, Brian, why does that matter? Why would I care that there's a microphone on my gimbal? Let me tell you why. When you're filming, when you're doing some cinematic filming, it's really nice to have some really sharp audio, right? But sometimes if you want to capture both at the same time, not sometimes, all the time, that's very hard unless you have a team of people. Here's an example, just like this.
Alan, our production shot could be anywhere in the world, and we chose to come right here to Allen, Texas. We're centrally located to all of the United States, and it's just been a-
Also, I've actually vlogged like this before on my boosted board, which yes, is ridiculous.
Let's get the boosted board up to full speed and see how smooth this gimbal is.
Your arm feels like it's gonna fall off and bleed from the interior to the exterior very quickly, but you know, it's doable. It really makes vlogging very, very smooth. The thing that people always ask, what other lenses can I put on this thing and it will be able to still fly it without a problem? Let's do a quick test. All right, so let me start by saying this is borderline ridiculous. Wait, again, it's not borderline. This is ridiculous. I'm gonna take off this 16 to 35 lens and I'm gonna put on this 70 to 200 lens, I believe. Yes, 70 to 200. That's a serious lens and totally unnecessary, but everything I do is unnecessary and why not continue that path? It's gotten me where I am today, right? All right, here it comes. Is this possible? It's on. It works. Now, is this totally unrealistic? Absolutely, that's why I did it. But if it can hold this, can it hold all those other lenses that you want to question me about? Absolutely it can. And if it can hold this, if you put anything else on here, I mean, seriously, I mean, that's silly. So this is proof. It can work. Do I recommend it? No. Is the footage gonna be very usable? Eh, maybe. But, whoa, this is by far the most amazing thing I've ever seen in a long time. There's a lot of settings that I really haven't gone over, like for example, the upside down. I gotta work on that. This is really good for getting those awesome low shots, and there's a whole bunch of other things this thing can do This thing also has the capability, if you're familiar with hyper time lapses, right? They're extremely hard to do them. If you've never done one before, you have to use a tripod, you take a picture, you move your camera forward however far you wanna go, and then you take another picture, and so on and so forth until you almost wanna die, or you do die. With this, you can actually choose one of the modes in here to stay focused in a certain area, and it will automatically move and stay on target to where it's supposed to be staying on target. That's insane. The other thing that's really cool about this, it has a mode on here what can actually rotate and spin. Now, one thing is knowing what is the best gimbal in the world. Which gimbal do you buy? Now, making things look good on a gimbal, that's a whole nother story. Just because it smooths out your walking and so on and your movements, it doesn't mean you can make things look good. If you guys wanna see a video on how to make things cinematic, let me know below. I'd love to make one of those because it's, for me, it's fun. Again, this is the Zhiyun 2. It is by far the most amazing gimbal in the world, 2018, according to my opinion. Thank you for watching today. If you like this video, make sure you smash that like button and share it with a few people. And while you're at it, subscribe. Just do it. You guys have an amazing night. I'll see you soon. Bye.